Honorable viewers, I welcome all of you to my YouTube channel, Department of English. Today, I would like to share with you Agamemnon written by Aeschylus. So let's get started. Agamemnon is a domestic tragedy. Agamemnon is a masterpiece of Aeschylus. It is one of the greatest Greek tragedies. It is a domestic tragedy in this sense that the hero Agamemnon is killed by his wife for having sacrificed his daughter Iphigenia. It is a tragedy of love and conspiracy. Clytemnestra, wife of Agamemnon and sister of Helen, has an illicit relation with Aegisthus, cousin of Agamemnon. Similarly, Agamemnon has a relation with Cassandra, daughter of Priam. Aegisthus has come to the place of Agamemnon to take revenge against Agamemnon. At the beginning of the play, we see a wise man who is waiting for giving bacon fire for the arrival of Agamemnon. Agamemnon will return from Troy. The wise man is thinking himself that he will proclaim at first the victory news of Greek. The second stage, we see the presence of Crux, the victory news of Greek. They mention the first bitter experience of Agamemnon. Agamemnon was totally unable to disobey the order of God Artemis. So he had to sacrifice his loving daughter Iphigenia in the deep sea at the time of going to Troy. It was a very pathetic moment for him. However, Agamemnon returns to his place by chariot. Cassandra was taken by another chariot. The chorus welcomes them and starts singing. Standing on the chariot, Agamemnon shows great respect to his own country, Argos. Clytemnestra appears and expresses her deep passion to her husband. She bursts into tears and says that she has passed many painful days when her husband was busy in Troy city. She has to wait day after day for her husband. She is very pleased now to see her husband. So she wants to give her husband a cordial reception. She offers for her husband red carpet reception. She orders her servants to cover the entire pot by a red carpet. They cover the whole pot according to the command of Clytemnestra. Agamemnon replies that his pain has removed in a large scale hearing his loving wife's statement. But he thinks that this admiration should have uttered by another person. He advises his wife not to receive by red carpet because it may bring vanity in his mind. This type of honor is only applicable for goddess, so it cannot be applicable for him. To take a red carpet reception indicates the disobedience to God. Only immortal God can move on this red carpet. Clytemnestra replies that while great heroes fulfill their wife's desires, so he should fulfill her little desire. Agamemnon could not avoid his wife's request. He orders his followers to take the foreign woman, Cassandra, in the place with great respect. Respect though, now she is a slave of Agamemnon. He has earned many valuable assets by capturing Troy, but this woman is the best asset among them. Agamemnon enters into the palace walking on the red carpet, but Cassandra doesn't agree to enter into the palace. She has a strong power of giving oracle, but nobody believes her oracle because of the influence of God Apollo. She discloses the secret plot against herself and Agamemnon before the chorus. She declares that very soon Clytemnestra will kill Agamemnon. She has offered for her husband a fake red carpet reception. Very soon, happy lamentation is heard. Agamemnon is being killed by his wife and Aeschylus. Now, Cassandra is very concerned about her coming death. She is totally unable to save herself in spite of being fortune teller. She will be killed as an animal in the foreign country. Before her death, she also predicts the worst. Son of Agamemnon will return from abroad and take revenge against his mother and Aeschylus. Agamemnon and Cassandra both have been killed. The fakeness of Clytemnestra is now clear to the chorus. But she thinks that she has done perfect of taking revenge of her daughter's death. The chorus leader blames her aunt Aeschylus. But she doesn't care them all at all because she has a faithful lover Aeschylus. Aeschylus will save him at the time of danger. The chorus leader denies the ruling of Clytemnestra. He also forbids her to join in the funeral occasion of Agamemnon. But she denies him. Now Aeschylus enters into the place. He is laughing for his successful mission. Actually, there are three reasons behind the killing of Agamemnon. They are: number one, killing of Iphigenia; number two, arrival of Cassandra with Agamemnon; number three, conflict between Agamemnon and Aeschylus. Atreus, father of Agamemnon, and Thestes, father of Aeschylus, were born of the same mother, but there was a conflict between the two brothers. For this, Thestes was exiled by Atreus. One day, Agamemnon compelled Thestes to eat flesh of his own son in a feast on the sea vessel. So, Aeschylus decides to take revenge against Agamemnon. Gradually, he makes illicit relation with Clytemnestra to take revenge. The chorus leader shows abhorrence to daughter them. Now she wants to live happily with her duplicate lover Aeschylus. The chorus leader curses them, saying that Orestes, son of Agamemnon, will take revenge after returning from abroad. So this is all about today's topic, Agamemnon, written by Aeschylus. As I mentioned before, that it's a domestic tragedy and it also a masterpiece of Aeschylus. Now also, it is one of the greatest Greek tragedies. It's a domestic tragedy in the sense that to the hero, Agamemnon is killed by his wife for having sacrificed his daughter Iphigenia. As I mentioned before, it is the tragedy of love and conspiracy. Clytemnestra, wife of Agamemnon and sister of Helen, has an illicit relation with Aeschylus, cousin of Agamemnon. Similarly, Agamemnon has a relation with Cassandra, daughter of Priam. Aeschylus has come to the place of Agamemnon to take revenge against Agamemnon. So that's all about today's topic. For the time being, thanks for patience hearing.